It's no secret that Cornwall is just the perfect place to enjoy the long, light evenings of British summertime. What sometimes causes some surprise is just how spectacular Cornwall is outside of the main season. Right from the moment you pull off the A30 onto the Cornish lanes, the adventure has really just started. Cornwall is renowned for its beautiful beaches, and it's not just the sunshine and the golden sands that make our rugged coastline spectacular. And a short walk with a crabbing net can reveal a world of rock pools and adventures just waiting for you and your loved ones to share. Of course, my advice would always be to warm up with a coffee or a hot chocolate, recharge your batteries, and then get back out there. You can't beat a walk across the sand dunes and a climb up Bray Hill, where at the top you'll just be treated to some of the best views in Cornwall. It's just a short walk back along the beach, and you can then hop on the ferry to Padstow. I'd just take a coffee and watch the fishing boats, watch the turning tide. It's a fantastic way to while away the afternoon. And of course, when you're ready, just give us a call and we'll send the Land Rover back down to pick you up. It doesn't matter how you've spent your day out there playing, come back in from the cold, unwind with a treatment at the Cowshed Spa and an evening swim. Cornwall is just an amazing foodie's paradise. Whether you enjoy an intimate romantic meal or a hearty breakfast so you can recharge your batteries ready for the next adventure. So if you ask a local or a returning guest at St Moritz, what's your favourite time of year in Cornwall? Don't be surprised if they tell you November or January and explain to you that the sea comes alive. Well, it just does in the amazing winter light we have down here. Or they might tell you it's just being tucked away out of the wind and spending a whole day lounging in the March sun. Every day is quite simply an adventure in Cornwall, no matter what time of year. And it's our pleasure to share at least some of your adventures here at the hotel. Sounds a cliche, but it's true. Cornwall, I just love it here in the winter. Come on, it's freezing out here. Bar hot toddies now.
Cornwall has a rich and fascinating history. Iconic engine houses bear silent testimony to the days when, for a short time, the county was the richest place in the world. Let Cornwall Living take you back in time as we take a look at how our traditions and landscapes have been shaped by generations of miners and fishermen.
It's hard to imagine now that once, not so long ago, Cornwall was the epicentre of a massive mining industry and was home to inventions that changed the world. Tin was a rare and valuable commodity. In ancient times, traders travelled from as far away as the Mediterranean to trade for tin at the legendary Isle of Ictus, St. Michael's Mount. Over time, miners began to follow the deposits of tin and copper ever deeper into the earth. In 1796, Camborne's Richard Trevithick invented a high-pressure boiler, and the golden age of Cornish mining was born. Steam-powered beam engines were introduced, enabling shafts to be driven thousands of feet deep into the hard rock, and tunnels extended out underneath the seabed for as far as 2 miles. On stormy days, miners could hear undersea rocks rolling around above their heads. Work was dangerous, conditions harsh, hours long. Accidents were common.
This week, 4 men have been injured at Cornbray Mines, and one poor fellow so badly injured at Wheal Peaver that he lived only a few hours after. Before those were admitted, there were in the accident ward 3 miners. One minus a leg, another a toe, another a hand.
The mines also required an extensive transport system to serve them. A vast network of roads, tramways and railways linking the harbours and foundries to the mines. The ports and harbours we see today were built to export copper and import coal. Our towns and villages were built to accommodate the thousands of miners. Uniquely Cornish sports evolved. Shay racing and Cornish wrestling. And the famous Cornish pasty was born. A meal in a crimped pastry pocket that would sustain the miner through his day's work. But increasing global competition forced the closure of Cornish mines and the migration of much of its mining workforce. South Crofty ceased production in March 1998, the last working tin mine in Europe. Today, Cornwall's mining landscape is quiet and tranquil, and few remember the days when Cornwall led the world.
Welcome to Michael Spire's Jewellers Truro, the Southwest premier diamond and watch house. As the only official retailer of the prestigious Patek Philippe brand in Cornwall, Michael Spire's has become a byword for excellence, distinction and uncompromising quality. The world's finest Swiss watches, including Rolex, Omega, Breitling and Tag Heuer. Discover designer jewellery brands, stunning diamonds and a friendly expert team to help and advise you. Michael Spire's, a passion for excellence.
There really is something for everyone, young or old, among Cornwall's premier attractions, which you can find on your Cornwall Living map. Let us do the legwork as we take a look at a few special days out around the county. Lose yourself in a world of maritime history at the National Maritime Museum Cornwall. Numerous stunning exhibitions beautifully illustrate our island nation, including the Search and Rescue exhibition. Ascend the 100-foot lookout tower, then descend into the depths of the tidal zone. With hands-on activities, talks, lectures, workshops and events, don't miss your chance for a visit. You will find more than you might expect. Tour Cornwall's Back Road Tours take you off the beaten track and show you the hidden gems that this stunning county has to offer. You can choose from a range of day trips, have your own car and guide, or join up with some friends and take a minibus tour. Either way, you get to relax, sit back, absorb your surroundings and enjoy this fabulous county. With themes such as Cornish food and wine, Cornish gardens, walking, heritage or wildlife, it's the perfect day out. Flambards for rides, park, museum and gardens has something for everyone. Step back to a bygone era and experience unique exhibitions, including the Victorian Village. Take a walk through history to the sights, sounds and smells that vividly depict the hardships of World War II. The 1-11 indoor play area is open 360 days of the year. If you are feeling daring, try over 25 rides and attractions. Flambard has to be the best day of the week. Discover Polgoon Vineyard and Orchard just outside Penzance. Polgoon produces a range of award-winning Cornish wines, ciders and fruit juices. Enjoy an interactive wine and cider tasting, or a guided tour with the winemaker, and gain a fascinating insight into the activities of a working Cornish winery. Visit Polgoon Vineyard and Orchard and discover one of West Cornwall's best kept secrets.
Whirlwind Sports, your local family owned sports shop. A friendly and relaxed atmosphere, catering for all types of sport, and offering a full range of products from top brands. See you in store to experience our professional advice for all your sporting needs, all year round. Stores on Lemon Quay, Truro, and also Helston, Camborne, and Penzance. Whirlwind Sports.
From sea to sand, coastline to countryside, Cornwall is the perfect place to kick back and relax. With an incredible selection of boutique shopping, modern galleries, artisan markets, and some of the country's finest restaurants in every Cornish town. This is how we at Cornwall Living see this great county of ours today.
Cornwall today has lost none of its picturesque charm, but has successfully combined that with what discerning visitors are looking for in 2013. In a county best known for its pasties, there's now cuisine to please even the most discerning palate. But it's not just fine dining that's evolved in the county. Using the best of local ingredients, small producers are creating delicious local specialties. Farmers markets are worth checking out. And there's always the freshest harvest of the sea. The sea has shaped Cornwall and is the reason why most people visit. And the county's become a major boating centre, with many marine events and festivals of the sea happening here. The ocean's our playground, where our seas are among the cleanest in Britain. Our eco credentials are impeccable. The beach is the centre of activity all year round. The amazing light and variety of subjects has led to Cornwall becoming a centre of the arts. Unlike most other places, small retailers still thrive in Cornwall, making it a great place to shop. And also a great place just to relax. This is modern Cornwall.
Renowned for its atmosphere, Ocean One provides a unique and eclectic blend of talented designers from all over Europe. The collections comprise a wide selection of fashion for different tastes, both classic and trend. Our aim is to provide discerning women with a destination for unique fashion labels that are stylish, elegant and original in relaxed and stress-free surroundings. Shops at Foy, Padstow and at Topsham, just outside Exeter.
With a landscape sculpted by the sea and a wealth of incredible properties, join Cornwall Living as we take a look at what the county has to offer the discerning buyer, whether that be a traditional cottage, a majestic manor house, or a stylish modern abode.
Cornwall's not only famous for its beautiful coastline, sandy beaches, fishing villages and countryside, but it's also widely recognised and regarded for its stunning properties lining its coves. The unique fishermen's cottages that make our coastal villages so charming, and its distinguished country homes. The history of the property in Cornwall has been shaped by its rich tin mining heritage, connection with fishing and the Atlantic Ocean. Its future is being shaped by our desire to strike that perfect life-work balance. With Cornwall now connected to the world with super-fast broadband, Cornwall offers the perfect location to work hard and enjoy life to the full, all against the backdrop of the Atlantic Ocean.
I think the property market in Cornwall is largely influenced by lifestyle living as well. It's not just about the property and the bricks and mortar, it's about the lifestyle that living in that area gives you. And indeed the properties are designed to maximise the light and the views invariably. So property here in Cornwall is really quite different to perhaps more urban properties, which is really lovely to be a part of, selling a lifestyle as well as a property. At Acorn we've bought some pretty sad and derelict hotels for our development sites, and we have given them some new life by creating new apartments, self-catering apartments on those locations. And so I guess really we've swapped what was a holiday bed for another type of holiday bed and more modern, contemporary accommodation. And I think that's been good for the economy. People are coming down and renting these properties, and I guess they eat out a lot and they go out and do things during the day, so they're putting a lot of money back into the economy as well. I'm incredibly lucky. My office overlooks Fistral Beach, and so at lunchtimes I do steal a few minutes and go for a walk across the beach, maybe just take a little paddle, clear the cobwebs and back to the desk in the afternoons.
We run our business on a very family orientation because my daughters work with me. The girls they went to school with, I employ. So it's very, very personal, and I hope very, very warm and welcoming. My experience with the property market from when I started in the last recession, so obviously it was quite difficult getting the business off the ground. And then obviously the market took off, I think, with the introduction of the internet and the fact you can come to Cornwall and then people can actually have communications. If they've got their businesses in London, people are still wanting to come to Cornwall. They still want to have their second homes here. Because it is a good investment, you can't really go wrong. I, as a person, have always been drawn to the sea. I've travelled an awful lot and I've lived in lots of different places, including cities and towns, but the sea has always had a pull for me. And once I moved to Padstow and could see the estuary, and it changes every single day. Every single morning you wake up, I still, even though I've lived in the same house for probably 36 years, I still wake up every single morning, look out, and it's a completely different scene, and I still say, wow.
So the property market in Cornwall is, I think, very different to anywhere else in the country. One day I could be going to see a charming little cottage, chocolate box cottage on a creek, and in that afternoon I'd be going to a modern contemporary clifftop house. The next day, farm on the moor. And you know, to have that variety in such close proximity, so variety of locations, and then within each location a totally different cross-section of types of property, and I haven't seen that anywhere else. I think in Cornwall, to me, what's always seemed special is you're never more than half an hour from the water, and so in one day you could go surfing in the morning, and in the afternoon you can go sailing. And there's not many places in the world you can do that, literally, and I, to a high standard. And I think that that's why Cornwall living is the ultimate lifestyle by the sea.
Not many people realise Cornwall Air Ambulance is charity funded. For over 25 years, we've provided a vital helicopter medical service to Cornwall and the Isles of Scilly. We fly 365 days a year and assist anyone in need of our help, young or old, visitor or local. Every year, we attend around 1,000 emergency missions, every one charity funded. Cornwall's stunning beaches are becoming increasingly popular. Whether it's a family day out, a walk on a coast path, or the water sports Cornwall's so famous for. Part of what makes the coast so enticing can be its remoteness. It's often these places that we're needed most.
What started off as a normal day down at the beach could have ended really differently if it hadn't been for the Cornwall Air Ambulance. My daughter Harriet, when she was just 9 years old, was dragged out to sea by a riptide.
We can be on our way to an incident within 3 minutes of a 999 call and can reach any part of mainland Cornwall in under 20 minutes. Often it's a race against time, and that's what Cornwall Air Ambulance is all about.
Come with us as Cornwall Living takes you on a journey through the sky. It's not until you experience the county's landscape from a bird's eye view that you can begin to grasp its true beauty and majesty.
Thank you.
Cornwall is unique in that you only have to take a few steps from the door of your hotel to be transported into paradise. Follow Cornwall Living as we take you off the beaten track to hidden corners in some of our favourite places.
North Cornwall is one of the most popular visitor destinations. Some of the UK's top celebrity chefs have taken up residence here, and it's becoming renowned for its food and fresh produce. Newquay is the country's home of surfing. But only a mile or two out of town, you can still find beautiful, uncrowded white sand beaches. There's a lot to experience on this coast. The Camel Estuary's Doom Bar has long been feared by seafarers, though within its shelter is a modern-day playground, amazing beaches, and the popular harbours of Rock and Padstow. The coastal path from bustling Port Isaac to Port Quinn is definitely worth a walk. And for the energetic, the Camel Cycle Trail follows a disused railway line between Wenford Bridge, Bodmin, Wade Bridge and Padstow, immortalised in Betjeman's Cornwall as the most beautiful train journey I know. The rugged and wild west of Cornwall is a trove of hidden delights, of wild moorland, Neolithic monuments, and tiny secluded fishing coves. The market town of Marazion and the fairy tale castle on St Michael's Mount are a must on any itinerary. The newly renovated Jubilee Pool is unique in the county. From Penzance, take a stroll along Cornwall's only prom to neighbouring Newlyn, where you can enjoy local art or the fresh fish landed at the market. West Penwith was a smuggler's coast, and the legends live on. The name of Lamorna's pub alludes to this, the wink being a signal that contraband could be obtained. The world-famous Minnock Theatre sits on the cliffs above one of Cornwall's most beautiful beaches, Porthcurno, where during the summer months, basking shark, those gentle giants, come close inshore. Everyone's heard of Land's End, but few visit dramatic Cape Cornwall. The beautiful clifftop road between Land's End and St Ives is undoubtedly one of the county's finest drives, providing stunning views over the Atlantic. It's a journey rich with history. St Ives is famous as Cornwall's artist capital. Its stunning light, blue skies and white sands have inspired many. And just across the mouth of the Hale Estuary, you can lose yourself on several miles of uncrowded golden sand beaches. Visiting the rich, rolling farmlands and quaint villages of South Cornwall is like stepping back in time. Close to Lostwithiel's 14th century bridge is Restormel Castle. Despite being over 1,000 years old, the castle has only once seen action, when it was fought over during the Civil War. Polperro's all about narrow, winding streets and tightly packed fishermen's houses. A reminder that the village was a major smuggling port for many centuries. A walk up the wild and impressive headland of Dodman Point is a must. its huge cross looking out over passing mariners. Mevagissey is still one of Cornwall's busiest fishing harbours. And not far away lie two of the county's major attractions, Eden and the Lost Gardens of Heligan. The deep water port of Foy is understandably a magnet for visitors, yet few bother to take the 5-minute ferry ride to Polruan just opposite, which is more than worth a visit. And even fewer head upriver to Lerin. Well hidden from the tourist trail, this stunning village spreads itself around both banks of the creek. Kenneth Graham based Wind in the Willows and the tales of Ratty and Mole on the riverbanks here. Lying on both sides of the river, Lewes just a great place to wander the quayside and to enjoy the town beach. Truro and Falmouth are for many the focal points of Cornwall, yet the countryside surrounding them is some of the county's richest, an area of rivers, estuaries, wild cliffs and lonely coves. A visit to Cornwall's capital city, Truro, is essential. The county's only cathedral town and its largest retail centre. There's always something going on in Cornwall's sailing capital, Falmouth, the world's third deepest natural harbour. Just a ferry ride across Carrick Roads is St Mawes. The castle here, and its sister on the Falmouth side, Pendennis Castle, were built by Henry VIII to guard the estuary against French invasion. You'll recognise the nearby lighthouse from the TV series Fraggle Rock. In the upper reaches of the River Fal, huge cargo ships laid up are always a surprise. Trellisic Gardens are a must to visit. The Helford River is all about ancient woodland and hidden villages, a playground for water sports enthusiasts. And its shady inlets the inspiration for Daphne du Maurier's Frenchman's Creek. Lizard Peninsula is a haven of small fishing villages like Cadgwith and of quiet coves. In the heart of Mounts Bay lies the picturesque fishing harbour of Porthleven. And close by is Cornwall's largest natural freshwater lake, the Low Pool. Separated from the ocean by a shingle bank, where the woodland trails and cycle tracks beckon.